I felt that by going back to my normal work of writing, I could be more useful.
In London, England, with war raging all around them, people need entertainment. But they don't want this. Although it may look like good old-fashioned fun, it's upset a lot of decent folk. The kids playing pigs are leading a revolution against the farmer. It's all based on a new book, Animal Farm. In an exclusive interview, its author, Britt George Orwell, gives us the lowdown on this showdown hoedown.
The actual details of the story didn't come to me for some time, until one day I saw a little boy, perhaps 10 years old, driving a huge cart horse along a narrow path and whipping it every time it tried to turn. It struck me that if only such animals became aware of their strength, we would have no power over them, and that men exploit animals in much the same way that the rich exploit the proletariat.
So it's the Russian Revolution in a barnyard. And Orwell pulls no punches. His pigs betray their own rebellion and start to rule like the human they overthrew. What he's trying to tell us is that the Russian communists can't be trusted, just when we've learned to get along with them. Only recently, the leaders of Britain, America, and Russia enjoyed a friendly supper party. They agreed on a grand design for smashing Germany and signed a lofty declaration ensuring a post-war world free from tyranny.
Orwell thought that people were much too much conned by the Soviet war effort into taking a favorable view of the government of the Soviet Union. This was, of course, the reason for writing Animal Farm at that time.
The kids love Animal Farm, but their parents won't get to read it. The book's not banned, but this is a story nobody wants to hear.
One publisher decided to consult the Ministry of Information, who appear to have warned him, or at least strongly advised him, against publishing it. He wrote... The fable does follow so completely the progress of the Russian Soviets and their two dictators that it can only apply to Russia. It would be less offensive if the predominant caste in the fable were not pigs. I think the choice of pigs as the ruling caste will no doubt give offense to many people, and particularly to anyone who is a bit touchy, as undoubtedly the Russians are.
Orwell says he won't keep quiet, even if the rest of his country wants him to.
Circus dogs jump when the trainer cracks his whip, but the really well-trained dog is the one that turns his somersault when there is no whip. And that is the state we have reached in this country, thanks to 300 years of living together without a civil war.
Animal Farm was the first book in which I tried, with full consciousness of what I was doing, to fuse political purpose and artistic purpose into one whole.
Some say politics has no place in art.
The opinion that art should have nothing to do with politics is itself a political attitude. What I most wanted was to turn political writing into an art.
Animal Farm was the first product of this approach, but before it was even published... You were considering 1984, were you not?
I thought of it in 1944.
In 1984, true love between individuals is impossible. Only hate is allowed, the only permissible love, for power. This bleak future you seem to be forecasting for Britain. Could totalitarianism really happen in a democracy like ours?
I do not think that the kind of society I describe will arrive, but that something resembling it could arrive, and that totalitarianism, if not fought against, could triumph anywhere.